Hey, Ernie.
Good morning, Gary.
Morning, morning. Ernie, I went quail hunting the other day, and I knew if I came to Dockside Cafe, you'd show me a good recipe to use. Do you have any ideas?
Man, Gary, I got a great one in mind, a nice wild mushroom braised quail. I'm going to get at it in the kitchen right now. Come meet me in the kitchen in a minute, Gary.
I'll see you in the kitchen in a few minutes.
Today, I'm going to cook one of my favorite dishes for quail, and I call it wild mushroom braised quail. So the first thing we're going to do is braise the quail. How are we gonna braise the quail? We get our heat going fast. I'm gonna put some of the wonderful garlic butter in the pan. We're gonna let that get hot, folks. We're gonna let that get good and hot, okay? Add a little bit of cracked pepper. A little bit of my crab ball seasoning, which I use like salt in my restaurant. A little bit of my Cajun blended seasoning. Then we're just gonna let this kind of simmer down. It's gotta get hot. As you can see, my grill gets hot really fast. Then we're gonna take all these wonderful quail that Gary has got for us. We're braising some quail right now. When I say braising it, we want to brown all the different sides of the quail. So right now we're basically browning off the quail in some garlic butter. One tip I can give you when you're doing wild game or you're doing birds, especially small birds like these quails, is don't overcook it. These birds cook very, very fast. That's why if you notice, I'm gonna braise these quail and I'm just gonna brown them off a little bit, then I'm gonna pull them out and I'm gonna add them back at the very end. And it's only gonna take, you know, we can have this dish ready in 15 minutes. I think a big mistake that a lot of people make when they're cooking with small fowl like this is they overcook it. That's what you don't wanna do. See, right now, guys, we're perfect right now. We got our quail braised. Now we're gonna go into cooking our mushroom gravy. Okay, now, folks, we wanna add our diced yellow onion to our butter mixture right here. And once these onions get a little translucent and they start to release their natural sugars, we're gonna add some white wine. Give it a little pizzazz. Woo! Smell that aroma. I wish you could smell it, folks. Smells fantastic. Okay, guys, now comes one of my favorite parts. We're gonna add two different types of wild mushrooms. Sliced up. Fresh wild mushrooms. I like using two different kinds. It gives you a little bit more depth to the sauce and really enhances the color. So here we go. Next, I'm gonna add a little bit of our beef stock. This is beef stock. You can use brown gravy. You could use Anjou. But I like a good beef stock in this. It's gonna give it a nice beefy flavor to the mushroom gravy. Bring a little saltiness to it and a little savoriness to it. I think you're gonna love it. Oh, baby. There's your wild mushroom gravy, Chef Ernie style. This is a really good old Cajun dish. And you know, Cajun cooking, a lot of people mistakenly think it's all about the heat, but it's not. It's all about the flavor, baby. It's about the layers of flavor that we put in there. Now, guys, we're gonna add our braised quail back into here. We're gonna let it cook in that broth. And that gravy, you know, this is a great dish. You know, you can cook this entire meal in one saute pan and do it in a hurry. You know, it's a great dish. It's a great dish when you're in a hurry. And you wouldn't believe the flavor that it packs, one heck of a flavor punch. So it's a fantastic dish. I'm glad I could show it to you tonight. I'm about to plate it up for you here in the kitchen. Then we're gonna take it to the table side. I'm gonna start off the dish with some of my wonderful Gouda cheese grits. I'm gonna do a nice mound of our Gouda cheese grits right here in the center. I'm gonna plate it up as if you were gonna eat it in my restaurant. We're gonna start off with two braised quail. One. Oh, that's a beautiful one. Look at that. Two. Now we're gonna take some of our wild mushroom gravy. You just pour it right there on the top of the dish. We're gonna take some fresh steamed hair caviars on the side. And then we're gonna top it off with my wonderful homemade fresh cranberry relish right there on top. Now that's what I call Cajun style. That's where most people make a mistake, Gary. When they're cooking a small fowl like this, they overcook the meat, it dries out, it's not juicy. Look how juicy that quail is, it's cooked perfectly.
It's got just a little pink to it.
Just a little pink, how you want it.
Oh, man.
Is that good?
I'm like you.
Is that killer?
That's killer, man.
Is that the best quail you ever had?
Best quail I ever had.
Thank you. I knew it would be. I had no doubt.